Hello, CA Foundation students. How are you? Hope so you all are good and doing well at your home, and hope so you have completed with maximum syllabus of your business economics and BCK, as if your exams are very near, it's just next month, and all of you are doing practice well of all of your MCQs and all of the things, as for objective paper, MCQ practice is very important and must. And I'm expecting that you have planned with all of your revisions for the upcoming month, and you are totally prepared for all of your exams which you are going to give in the month of December, and you will be able to crack it in first go, guys. So once again, Prachi Pani on this side will teach you economics and BCK for CA Foundation December 2021. Okay, so guys, in today's lecture I am going to teach you very important concept related to market, that is what price determination. So before starting up with the lecture of price determination, let us discuss some of the basic information. Okay, so for having the latest update regarding all of the live lectures, you have to join the Telegram channel. So the link of the Telegram channel, the CA Foundation English Telegram channel link, is given below in the description box, and you have to join that channel, your Telegram channel, for having the latest update regarding all of the lectures. Okay guys, after that, this is what the schedule which we are having for the month of October. So I want you to make a note for this, so that you will be able to attend all of the lectures of maths, law and economics. Please make a note of this, guys. Okay, apart from this, as you all know, you have to install the Unacademy's learning app, so that you will be able to have the benefit of free special classes. And apart from that, you will be also able to subscribe for Plus and Iconic courses, and you will get the maximum benefit for the particular course. You will install the Unacademy's learning app, so you will be able to subscribe for Plus courses and for Iconic courses. So if you will go for Plus courses, so it will be like you will be have the benefit of live classes, weekly tests, structured course and unlimited classes. And you will go for Iconic subscription, so apart from the Plus benefits, you will also have some extra benefit as personal guidance, study planner, study material, expert guideline and test. As you all know, Unacademy is a very big platform, and there are best educators, India's best educators, which we are having. So there are many more simultaneous batch which are streaming, and you can have the benefit of that too also. That is what the biggest advantage Unacademy provide you, that you can choose your educator by your own. As you are getting the subscription for Plus and Iconic, so you are free to attend the class of any of the educator which you like. Okay? Apart from this, as there are different subscription plan for Plus subscription and Iconic subscription. So as if you will go for Plus subscription, there are different plans with different fee structure. So you can go for 3-month subscription, 6-month subscription, 12-month subscription and 24-month subscription. For that, the fees which you are having is 9,000, 10,800, 14,400 and 19,800. And you are eligible to get the discount by using the code PRACHI10. As if you are using the code PRACHI10, you are able to get the maximum discount as you are subscribing for Plus courses. Either if you will go for Iconic subscription, so for Iconic subscription also we are having different plans with different fee structure. As you can see, we are having 6-month plan, 12-month plan and 24-month plan with fee structure of 22,500, 31,500 and 52,500. So you can go with this also with some extra benefits, and you will be able to get the discount by code PRACHI10. So you can use the code PRACHI10 and you will be able to get maximum discount. Is it clear? Okay. So let us start with the lecture. As you all know, in the last lecture, I have told you about market concepts of PR, AR and MR. So today I am going to tell you the concept related to determination of price. Okay. So today we are going to discuss determination of price, the concept which is there in your unit number 4, market. Earlier we have seen classification of market, we have also seen the concept of PR, AR and MR, and today we are going to see the concept of determination of price, which is given there in the chapter market. So it is a very important concept from the chapter market. We are going to discuss it today. All know guys, price is a very important element in the market. And price is very important from the point of view of supplier also, from the point of view of consumer also. Because if we are not having the price of the commodity, then how we will be able to do the transaction? then how we will be able to do the exchange of commodities. So price is a very important element, and to determine the price is also very important element. So there is a particular method, there is a particular process to determine the price of the company. So price determination is also a very important aspect related to market. As because if you are not having the price of the commodity, then how you will be able to do the transaction. So to do the transaction, price is very important. So determination of price is also very important. As price is very important, so you should determine the price of the commodity. No. So determination of price we are going to study in today's lecture. As if in free market, the price is determined on the basis of demand and supply. So under the free market, if you want to determine the price of the commodity, so you will be able to determine the price of the commodity with the help of the demand and supply. Is it clear? So when the demand and supply is going to interact with each other, at that time the prevailing price will be your equilibrium price. The price which you will decide on the basis of demand and supply, on the basis of interaction of demand and supply, so that price will be known as your equilibrium price. Is it clear? So you are going to decide the price of the commodity on the basis of demand and supply, on the interaction of demand and supply. So furthermore, interaction of demand and supply tends to determine the equilibrium price. So whenever your demand and supply will interact with each other, at that time the prevailing price in that situation will be your equilibrium price. So whatever the price which you decide on the interaction of demand and supply, that price is known as your equilibrium price. Please make a note for this. What did I say? Whatever the price which you decide on the interaction of demand and supply, that price is known as your equilibrium price. Is it clear? Now you will ask me, ma'am, what is the state of equilibrium? What do you mean by equilibrium? So equilibrium is a position when the demand is equals to supply. So when the quantity supplied is equals to quantity demanded, it's all about the position of your equilibrium. That is means what? You are having an equilibrium position when your demand is equal to supply. So when your demand is equal to supply and you are having the equilibrium position, at that time the prevailing price will be known as your equilibrium price. Is it clear? Ma'am, you have told us all the things theoretically. Please explain us with the help of some examples, schedule and graph, so that the concept will be more clear for us. Sure. So just have a recap. Before proceeding further with the schedule and example, we will have a recap for that. As what they are saying, the determination of price is a very important aspect. Because price is a very important element of a market. As if you will not have the price, you will be not able to do the transaction. Price of the commodity is very important, which you should know. Okay. So, how you will determine the price of the commodity? So, the price of the commodity is determined on the basis of demand and supply force. So whenever your demand and supply will interact with each other, with the help of that you will be able to decide the price of the commodity. So when the demand and supply are equal to each other, so that is what the position of equilibrium you are having, and at that time the prevailing price will be known as your equilibrium. This is what the recap I have given you. Now I will give you the schedule, and with the help of this schedule and graph you will be able to understand the concept of equilibrium price more better. Okay. As you can see in my example, your price is what? Your price is increasing. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, your price is increasing. And what is going to happen to demand when your price is increasing? So what will be your demand? What will be the demand? What is the demand reaction at that time? Your demand will decrease. So whenever the price is increasing, at that time the demand is decreasing, as because price and demand is having the inverse relationship with each other. So whenever your price will increase, your demand will decrease. So as you can see in my example, the price is increasing, so as the demand is decreasing. Is it clear? Now, as we want both, now we want demand also and we want supply also, then only we will be able to decide the price, then only we will be able to determine the equilibrium price. So we have seen demand, as price is increasing, so demand is decreasing. Now we are having supply. As you all know, price and supply is having direct relationship with each other. What did I say? Price and supply is having direct relationship with each other. So as if the price is increasing, supply is also increasing. What did I say? As if the price is increasing, supply is also increasing. We are having both demand and supply. As you can see in this schedule, there is a situation when demand and supply are interacting with each other. That is what demand and supply are equal to each other. And I think you all are able to see that situation. Just one second. This is what the situation when your demand and supply is equals to each other. Your demand is also what? 300. And your supply is also what? 300. That means what? Demand is equals to supply. So at that time, the prevailing price is your what? Equilibrium price. So as you can see, when your demand n is equal to supply, so at that time your prevailing price is what? 30. So 30 will be your equilibrium price. That is what I was telling you theoretically earlier. That whenever your demand is equal to supply, they are interacting with each other. That time the prevailing price will be known as your equilibrium price. So when your demand and supply is equal to each other, that is what the position of equilibrium. At that time, the prevailing price will be known as your what? Equilibrium. Is it clear? Now, with the help of that schedule, we are having this graph, as you can see. You are having the demand curve, you are having the supply. Okay? And demand and supply curve are interacting at one point. They are interacting at one point, and that interaction indicates that. That interaction indicates that demand is equals to supply. Because things are interacting when only, then they are equal to each other. Is it clear? So when demand and supply are interacting to each other, that is the point of your equilibrium, indicating that demand is equals to supply. And at that time, the prevailing price will be your equilibrium price. So 30 will be your equilibrium price. Because at that time, your demand is equals to supply. Is it clear? Your demand is also 300 and your supply is also 300. That is why they both are interacting with each other. And at that time, the prevailing price is 30. So that will be your equilibrium. It's clear to everyone. Now, there are two cases which we have to study. Listen to me very carefully. There are two cases which we have to study. As there can be two situations where your market price is less than your equilibrium price and your market price is more than your equilibrium price. So what is going to happen? Listen to me. I will explain you this with the help of this schedule. Before the equilibrium price, you can see your market price is less than your equilibrium price. As you can see, 10, 20, less than 30. Before equilibrium price, your market price is what? Less than your what? Equilibrium price. And when your market price is less than your equilibrium price, this situation indicates that you are having excess demand. This situation indicates that you are having excess demand. And as you can see in the schedule also, initially your demand is excess than your supply. Demand is 500, supply is 100, demand is 400, supply is 200. That means what? Your demand is excess as compared to the supply. That means there is a shortage of supply and excess of demand. But you don't want this situation. You want the situation where the demand is equal to supply. So, to solve this situation, what you will do? You will increase your price. What you will do? You will increase your price to reach the position of equilibrium. So, when your market price is less than your equilibrium price, that means it is a situation of excess demand. And to solve the situation of excess demand, what you will do, you will increase your price to reach the position of equilibrium price, and you will reach to the position when your demand is equal to supply. This is the first situation. So in first situation, when your market price is less than your equilibrium price, that means it is a situation of excess demand. And to solve the situation of excess demand, what you will do, you will increase the price. So, the demand will be less and demand and supply will be equal to each other and you will be able to get your equilibrium. First situation. Second situation. As you can see, after the equilibrium price, when your equilibrium price, when your market price is more than your equilibrium price, what did I say? After the equilibrium price, you can see when your market price is more than your equilibrium price. That means it is a situation of excess supply. But you want the position of demand is equals to supply. So what you will do when there is a situation of excess supply, you will decrease your price. What you will do? You will decrease your price. As you will decrease your price, so the demand will be more and supply and demand will come equal, and you will be able to get the position of equilibrium. And with the help of that, you will be able to get the equilibrium price. So when there is a situation when the market price is more than your equilibrium price, that is a situation of excess supply. And to solve that situation of excess supply, what you will do? You will decrease the price to reach the equilibrium price and to reach the equilibrium position. Is it clear, everyone? Is it clear, everyone? So when you are having excess demand, at that time you will increase the price. And when you are having excess supply, at that time you will decrease the price. And this you are doing to reach the position of equilibrium and for having the equilibrium price. This is what the introduction which I have given you, and I have given you how the equilibrium price is being determined. Is it clear? So first I have told you that in free market, price is determined on the basis of demand and supply forces. Interaction of demand and supply leads to determination of price. Equilibrium is a position where demand equals to supply. And at that time, the prevailing price will be known as your equilibrium price. For that, we have seen one schedule also, where we have seen the price is increasing, demand is decreasing, and supply is increasing. So when the demand and supply are equal to each other, that is what your position of equilibrium, and at that time the prevailing price will be your equilibrium price. Okay. With this, we are having two situations, and we have to solve that two. So whenever there is a situation of excess demand, so you will decrease your price to reach the position of equilibrium, and whenever there is a situation of excess supply, so you will decrease your price to reach the position of equilibrium. Is it clear? And that is what you can also treat this situation as, when your market price is less than your equilibrium price, excess demand situation. And when your market price is more than your equilibrium price, so that will be the situation of your excess. So hope so you guys is able to understand whatever the things which I've tried to tell you. Okay. And we have determined simply the equilibrium price with the help of the interaction of demand. Now we are going to see some of the changes in this equilibrium price and how that changes take place one by one. So the first situation which we are having is, there is only change in demand, and what they are saying, change in demand, and change in demand leads towards increase in demand and decrease in demand. Okay. So what is going to happen when there is a change in demand? What will be the effect on equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity? Okay, see, I will tell you once again. The price which you have decided, that is what equilibrium price. Okay, and at that price, the quantity demanded and quantity supplied is known as your equilibrium quantity. Whatever the quantity which you are supplying and whatever the quantity which you are demanding at the equilibrium price is known as your equilibrium quantity. Is it clear? Now, so when there is only change in demand, so what will be the change in equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity, that we are going to study. And this is the common graph which you have to consider for all of the graphs which I am going to tell you right now. So the first thing which we are going to see is, there is only change in demand. What we are going to see is, there is only change in demand and there is no change in supply. So what is going to happen to equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity? Let us see. And please, you have to concentrate on the screen while I am making the graph. And I will say all of the things and I will train you with the help of the camera. Okay. Oh, sorry. And it will take some time, so you have to keep patience while I am making the graphs. Clear? So the common one, the original one, we are having this supply curve and we are having this demand curve. I will not have every time different colors to explain you, because it will take much time. And here also we are having the original demand and original supply. This is the common thing which we are going to have. This is the common thing which we are going to have. Okay. So this is what we are having, the original demand, the original demand and original supply curve, the original equilibrium price which we are having. And now we are going to study that as if there is a change in demand, so what will be a change in original equilibrium price and original equilibrium quantity. So this is what your demand curve, this is what your supply curve, this is what your demand curve, this is what your, sorry, this is what your demand curve, and this is what, and this is what your original equilibrium price which you have here. This is what your original equilibrium price which you have. Y axis, x axis, here equilibrium price, and here equilibrium quantity. Equilibrium price, equilibrium quantity. One by one I am going to explain you. Don't worry. Okay. So now this is what the original which you are having, equilibrium equilibrium original price. Original equilibrium price we are having, and original equilibrium quantity. We are having demand supply, this is what the common thing which we have studied. How we have reached to this we have studied earlier. Now, what they are saying, there is a change in demand. That means there is a only change in demand and supply will not change. Only single variable is changing here, that is what demand and supply will not change. As if there is a change in demand, so what is going to happen? Let us discuss to the equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity. So the first case is there is a change in demand, and that is what, there is an increase in demand. So in the first case there is an increase in demand, and whenever we are having increase in demand, so there is a rightward shift. So let us do that. Whenever we are having increase in demand, there is a rightward shift. So let us do that. There is an increase in demand. We are having new demand curve and supply curve will be as it is. So I think you can see that you have got a new equilibrium position and new equilibrium price. That is what E1. Whatever the things which you are having new, that will indicate with the help of 1. As when there is an increase in demand and no change in supply, as you can see, there we are having new equilibrium price and new equilibrium quantity. You can, with the help of this, when you will say no, then only you will be able to come to know, and you will draw. You will be able to come to know the new equilibrium price and new equilibrium quantity. As you can see earlier, you were having equilibrium price. Okay, and when you have drawn the new demand curve, the increase in demand curve, the new interaction point which you have got of demand and supply, that is what E1. So this is what the new interaction point which you have got with the help of increase in demand. So that will be your new equilibrium price. That will be your new equilibrium price and new equilibrium position. As you are having new equilibrium price and new equilibrium quantity, as you can see, the equilibrium price is also increasing and equilibrium quantity is also increasing. The equilibrium price, that EP1 and EQ1. You are having new equilibrium price and new equilibrium quantity. You will draw it now. Itself only you will get all of the things. Okay. Now, so this was what the case of increase in demand. So when there is an increase in demand, that means what, there is a rightward shift in the demand curve and supply curve will be same as it is. As we have shifted the demand to rightward, so you are having new interaction point, and that new interaction point will give you the new equilibrium quantity and new equilibrium price. It's clear, everyone? It's clear? Next. Now, the next case is what? Decrease in demand. When decrease in demand, there is a leftward shift. I will do a leftward shift in decrease in demand. Yes, this is what the leftward shift which we have done. The leftward shift, we are having new demand curve right now, and we have got a new interaction point of demand and supply. That is what this. That means E1 we have got it. And with the help of this, you are getting new equilibrium price and new equilibrium quantity. So this is what EP1 you are having and EQ1 you are having. Is it clear? And you can see here the equilibrium price is also decreasing and equilibrium quantity is also decreasing. Is it clear? So this was the case of change in demand. So when there is a concept of change in demand, there will be an increase in demand and there will be a decrease in demand, and supply will remain constant as it is, as it was before. And with the help of increase in demand and decrease in demand, you will be able to get new equilibrium price and new equilibrium quantity. Is it clear? Is it clear? And they can ask you as MCQ, and there is a change in demand, so what is the effect in equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity? So what we will do, don't make it ratta, don't mug up. What you have to do is, when you are having a pen and paper with you at the time of exam, draw. Just draw it. Whatever the situation they are giving you, draw it, and you will be able to come to know itself only what is happening to equilibrium price and what is happening to equilibrium quantity. Simple as that. Okay. Now, opposite situation. Now the demand is not going to change and the supply is going to change. So there is a change in supply and demand will remain as it is, and there will be increase in supply and there will be decrease in supply. So let us see what is going to happen, the same thing which we are going to do right now. Okay, so this is what the original demand supply which we are having, original equilibrium price we are having. Let me mark it fast. This is what the demand curve, supply curve, demand curve, supply curve, X. And I will also give you homework to do. I will tell you what you have to do by yourself. This is what the original equilibrium price and quantity you are having. Original equilibrium price and quantity. Okay. Now what is happening? I will take. So the first situation is what? There is an increase in supply. So when there is an increase in supply, what is happening? There is a rightward shift. So let us do an increase in supply. This is what the increase in supply curve you are having. And whenever you are having a new curve, so you mark it as S1. And demand curve is as it is. Can see you are having a new interaction point. So this is what your new interaction point, that is equilibrium 1. And with the help of this new interaction point, you are getting the new equilibrium price and new equilibrium quantity. This is what the new equilibrium price and new equilibrium quantity you are getting. You can see with the increase in supply, your equilibrium price is decreasing and your equilibrium quantity is increasing. This is what new equilibrium price you have got with the help of increase in supply. So when you are having increase in supply, at that time you have got new equilibrium price and new equilibrium quantity and new interaction point. Is it clear? Now, the next concept. What is happening? There is a decrease in supply. So when there is a decrease in supply, means what? There will be a leftward shift. So this is what the leftward shift which you are having. This is what S1. Decrease in supply, no, and here it was increase. So you are getting new interaction point. So when you are getting new interaction point, new equilibrium position, and demand and supply interacting once again with each other with new interaction point, and the supply is decreasing. So you will get new equilibrium price and new equilibrium quantity. And as here you can see, your EP is what increasing, and your EQ is what decreasing. And you will draw it, no, itself only automatically you will get the change. Automatically only you will get the change. So this is what you have to do. And any question related to this aspect is being asked in exam, no. So just you have to take your pen and paper and you have to draw it. So the situation which we have seen right now, there was only change in demand and there was only change in supply. And now you are going to study with me that there is a simultaneous change in demand and supply. Both demand and supply are changing simultaneously. And to remember this, I know this is a very complex concept which I am going to teach you right now, the simultaneous change in demand and supply. But I will teach you this in a very, very, very easy manner. And I am going to give you homework also for this related concept. Is it clear? Okay. So what is going to happen here is, there are four situations. There are four situations in which the demand and supply are going to change simultaneously. In the earlier concept which I have told you right now, in the situation where, in the first situation there was only change in demand, and in the second situation there was only change in supply. But the situation which I am going to teach you right now is there is a simultaneous change in demand and supply. Matlab demand is also going to change and supply is also going to change. And there are four situations. How many situations we are having? Four. The first situation is, and I want you to draw this chart. so that you will be able to understand. Okay, so the first situation is demand is increasing and demand is increasing and supply is also increasing. Okay, second situation, demand is decreasing, supply is also decreasing. Okay, third situation, demand is increasing, supply is decreasing. Fourth situation, demand is decreasing, supply is increasing. So probabilities which we are having, so this four situation can be there, as both can increase, both can decrease, one can increase and another can decrease. Is it clear? And this four major situations, we are having three basic situations. In this four major situations, we are having three criteria, as both demand and supply are increasing. So both demand and supply can increase with equal percentage, as demand is also increasing by 50% and supply is also increasing by 50%. And it can also happen that demand is increasing by 70% and supply is increasing by 50%. And it can also happen that demand is decreasing by 25% and supply is increasing by 50%. So these are the three cases which can happen commonly in all of the four situations. Here also same can happen. They can decrease equally, more than or less than. Here also they can have that same thing. One can increase and decrease ratio can be equal, more than and less than. It can also happen in the fourth case also, as they can also increase and decrease equally, more than. Percentage will vary. So these are the situations which can be there while determining the equilibrium price. These are the situations. Ma'am, we are not able to understand whatever the things which you have told us. Only we are able to understand the four head situation: increase, increase, decrease, decrease, increase, decrease. But the things which you have written right now, ma'am, three situations equals to more than and less than, we are not able to understand. So what I will do? See, two situations are similar to each other and two situations are similar to each other. So in my lecture, I will teach you these two concepts. Okay? One from these two and one from these two. And another two which I am not telling you, which are similar to that, you are going to do at your home and this will be your homework. Is it clear? When I will tell you about the increase one, so decrease one will be your homework. And when I will tell you the one situation of increase and decrease, so the another situation of increase and decrease, you will do it by your own at your home. Is it clear? So let us start. I'm going to tell you the first situation. Just listen to me. When you will listen to me, the situation, you will be able to understand what I'm trying to teach you. The first situation when you are having is demand is increasing and supply is also increasing. In that, we are having three cases. How many cases we are having? Three cases. I know you are saying, you must be thinking that, man, we are getting bored, but see, this concept is like very complex. I want to teach you, in a very simple, brief and clear manner. I don't want to make it complex for you always. And I'm taking this concept for that purpose only, so that you will be able to be very clear related to this concept. This concept is very difficult. Okay. So the first case is what equals to. The second case is what more than, and the third case is what less. So in the first case, demand and supply both are increasing by 50%. Demand and supply both are increasing by 50%. That means demand is also increasing by 50% and supply is also increasing by 50%. Okay. So let us draw the graph. So first we will have the original one. So this is what the original one which we are having: demand, supply, y, x. Here we are having quantity and here we are having price. What the original you are having. Now what is happening? Tell me fast. Demand is also increasing and supply is also increasing, but that too with same ratio. So one by one we will draw. Okay. So first we will draw the demand. So there is an increase in demand with 50%. So there is a rightward shift. See, I have drawn the increase in demand by 50%. D1. And and the same I have to draw for what? The same I have to draw for supply also. Now, the supply is also increased by 50%. The same percentage is there, so supply is also increased. This is what S1. This is what the S1 you are having. And now you can see कि when there is a same percentage increase in the demand and supply, so as you can see the equilibrium price is same. See, this was the original equilibrium price which you were having earlier, and when you are having the new demand and supply curve, and when you are having the new demand supply curve and interaction of new demand and supply curve, so at that time you can see at the same position you are having the interaction. At that time you can see the equilibrium price is same, but the equilibrium quantity is being increased. Is it clear? But the equilibrium quantity is being increased. Equilibrium quantity is being increased, but there is no change in equilibrium price. They are getting interacted at the same position as they were earlier. Is it clear? As you can see, no, the equilibrium price line is going straight. Earlier, see, I'm marking with black. The original one was this, and the new one was this. That means there is no change in equilibrium price. It is same, it is constant. Is it clear? Well, another situation where we can say demand is increasing by 70% and supply is increasing by 25%. Is it clear? So the second situation is demand is increasing by 70% and the supply is increasing by, no, demand we can say 75% and supply is increasing by 25%. So let us have the graph for this and let us check the equilibrium quantity and price. And with the help of each and every situation, you will be able to come to know what is the change between equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity. When the demand and supply are increasing in the same percentage, so at that time your equilibrium price is not having any kind of change, but your equilibrium quantity is being increased. So this is what they will ask you the question in the exams. They will give you the situation and they will ask you the change in equilibrium price and quantity. So I will suggest you that fatafat draw it with the help of pen and paper, and you will be able to come to know what is the change is going to be happening there. Now, okay, this is what original demand, original supply curve which we are having. Original demand, original supply by X0, original E, EP and quantity. Now we will draw the situations. What is going to happen? There is an increase in, both are increasing, but that too in a different percent. There is an increase in demand by 75%. Sorry. There is an increase in demand by 75%. That is what new demand curve we are having. And there is a decrease, there is an increase in supply with 25%. There is an increase in supply 25%. You can see you are having new interaction point, that is what this. So the original which you are having was this. Original which you are having was this. This was your original equilibrium price and original equilibrium quantity. And when you have changed it, then when you are having an increase in demand by 75% and increase in supply by 25%. So you are having a new interaction point, that is what your E1, that is what your E1 you are having. And with the help of that new demand curve and supply curve and interaction, that increase in demand by 75% and increase in supply by 25%, you are having new equilibrium price and new equilibrium quantity. As you can see, this is what the new equilibrium price and new equilibrium quantity. As you can see, equilibrium price is also increasing and equilibrium quantity is also increasing. This is what is going to happen. Is it clear? Last case. Last case is what? Your demand is increasing by 25% and your supply is increasing by 75%. Totally opposite. So let us have the graph for it. Okay. Original demand, original supply, original equilibrium price, original equilibrium quantity. Now the situation we are going to draw is, what is going to happen? The demand is going to increase by 25%. So this is the increase in demand by 25%. That is what this is your new demand curve. And increase in supply is by what? The increase in supply is by 75%. Increase in supply, 75%. S1. As you can see, this is your new interaction point. So you will be able to get your new equilibrium price and new equilibrium quantity. So as you can see, your equilibrium price is decreasing and your equilibrium quantity is increasing. Is it clear? Your equilibrium price is decreasing and your equilibrium quantity is what? Increasing. Equilibrium price is increasing and equilibrium quantity is what? Increasing. Is it clear? As you will draw it by yourself only, na? With the help of that drawing only, with the help of that graph only, you will be able to come to know what is increasing and what is decreasing. So at the time of exam, I want to suggest you that whenever this type of question is there, you should draw so that you will be able to come to know. So I have explained you the first case that I have done. And the second case is homework for you all. In the same manner, you are going to draw the second case and you will be come to the conclusion that what is the impact on equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity with the change in demand and supply. Is it clear? And the last case of this lecture, which I am going to tell you from my side, is what? Increase in demand and decrease in supply. Opposite also I have to take, na? And the another situation with the same case, you are going to do it by your own. It will be your homework. So let us discuss the last case quickly, guys. And I think so my students are able to understand what I have tried to explain. So the last case which we are having is demand is increasing and supply is decreasing. Okay. Here also we are having three situations, guys. So where demand and supply are, demand is increasing and supply is decreasing at an equal percentage, more than and less than. So first we are going to have the equal percentage. That means what? Demand is increasing by 50% and supply is decreasing by 50%. Opposite is going to happen. So let's see when the things are going to be opposite, what will be the change in equilibrium price and quantity. Let us discuss. And you have to be very, you know, attentive while doing this, as it is very confusing. Okay, so this is what the original supply, original demand and original supply we are having. Okay, original demand, original supply. Now we are going to work according to the situation. So first we will think about the demand. So demand is increasing by 50%. Demand is increasing by 50%, so that means there will be a rightward shift. Yes, demand is increased by 50%. Now next is what? Ma'am, supply decreased by 50%. So opposite direction we will go. There will be a leftward shift. Supply decreased by 50%. Supply decreased by 50%. That is what you are having, new supply curve N1, and we are having new demand. As you can see, there is a new interaction point, and this in new interaction point you have come to an end that your equilibrium price is increasing, but there is no change in your equilibrium quantity. As you can see, the equilibrium quantity is constant, vertical straight only there. As you can see, the same equilibrium quantity is being moved up with the change in new demand and supply curve which we are having. As you can see, there is no change in equilibrium quantity, but there is a change in equilibrium price, as your equilibrium price is there to 10 to 15, but your equilibrium quantity is all as there is 100 only. As there is no change in equilibrium quantity, but there is a change in equilibrium price. You draw properly, it will be go according to the things only which you will draw. Is it clear? Next case. The demand is increasing by 75% and supply is decreasing by 25%. So let us draw this graph. Opposite we are doing here. Okay, this is what your demand curve, supply curve which we are having. Demand, supply, original. What is going to happen? Now tell me fast, you are going to tell me. The demand is going to increase by 75% and there is an increase in demand, that means there will be a rightward shift. there is an increase in demand by 75%. And what is going to happen to supply? Ma'am, supply is decreasing by 25%. Supply decreased by 25%. That means you are having new supply curve, you are having new demand curve also. So where is your, this is your original interaction point. So where is your new interaction point, guys? Tell me fast. I think this is your new interaction point with you. And as you can see here, your equilibrium price is also increasing and your equilibrium quantity is also increasing. So this is what you are having the new interaction. Is it clear, everyone? Is it clear? As you can see, your equilibrium price is also increasing and your equilibrium quantity is also increasing. Is it clear to everyone? Very good. Okay, next case, last situation, when there is a increase in demand by 25% opposite and decrease in supply by 75%. Last case of this lecture. Okay, so we will have original demand, original supply. Guys, you all are making with me, na? Yes, you have to draw with me that you will be able to come to know. And I think this is the concept which is more difficult for every students as they open up the module and all the notes. They see so many notes. I don't want to study. God, it is so hectic. But I think I have made it very easy and clear for you. This is what the original which you are having. Okay. Now, what is the situation? The demand is increasing by 25%. What is going to happen? The demand is increasing by 25%. And the supply is decreasing by, you have to go in opposite section. The supply is decreasing by 75%. The supply is decreasing by 75%. As this is your S1, this is your D1 which you are having. And this is what the new interaction point which you have get. And as you can see, the equilibrium price is increasing, but the equilibrium quantity is decreasing. Equilibrium price is what? Equilibrium price is what? Increasing. And your equilibrium quantity is what? Decreasing. So equilibrium price increase and equilibrium quantity decrease. Is it clear? And the remaining two cases, which I have not done, will be your homework and you have to try it by yourself that you are able to make that and you are able to understand that or not. And you are getting the new equilibrium price and quantity or not. As in the exam, they will ask you as if there will be a change in demand or supply. So, what will be the impact on equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity? So, this was all about the determination of price. And I tried my level best to make you this concept very clear in a very brief and specific manner. Okay. So, what we have seen today, we have seen the price determination is very important and it is done with the help of demand and supply. Then we have seen the schedule. Then we have seen the graph. This is the original graph which you have to consider. And then we have seen whenever there will be a changes, then what will be the impact on equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity. Individually, first we have seen change in demand, then we have seen change in supply. After that, we have seen simultaneous change in demand and supply. And there are four cases in that and three subcases. Okay, so with this, I am going to end up with today's lecture. Hope so you guys have liked this lecture. Please drop your comment related to this lecture, okay, in the comment box. With this, I will take a leave, guys, and I want you to install the Unacademy's learning app if you have not installed till now. It will be a great help for you all, and special classes are totally free. You will be able to do the MCQ practice because many of the educators take the MCQ session in the special classes as we are having the poll. With the help of poll, you can test yourself. Apart from that, Iconic subscription is the best pocket saver opportunity which you are having. Combination of CA foundation and intermediate combo both with the fees of 47 and 80,000 for 12 months and 24 months. And here also you are eligible to get the discount of 10% by using the code Pratitude. Follow my profile on Unacademy's website. The link of my profile is given below in the description box. Then you will be able to get all the latest update regarding my lectures. Thank you guys for being there. It was a great lecture with you all, guys. Okay, take care, tada, bye-bye, take care of your health, be confident, study well, study hard, all the best guys, bye-bye everyone, take care. whatever the things which I have told you, you have to make a note for that so that you will be able to make it clear, okay?